This particular animal is definitely not on Hosanna's menu. Partly because it's in Kenya, but also because it might just be just that little bit out of his range. As brave and strong as Hosanna has proved himself to be, I don't think hunting a giraffe is on his list of to-do things. We've spoken before about the differences in the giraffe here versus the Southern African giraffe. And this Maasai giraffe is giving us... Well, he's keeping a close eye on us, nevertheless. But I spoke about the prominence of the bump in the middle of the forehead on this particular species of giraffe. And just look at this. Okay, this is a relatively understated example of what it is I was talking about. But obviously the ossicones, oi, keep your head in shot, mister, while we're talking about it. Obviously the ossicones are very prominent. That's always the case with a male giraffe. But if you look at the bump in the middle of his head, that's obviously in this area, has also come in very useful in terms of being an extra weapon when fighting another male. Now the giraffe on Jumo and the Sabi Sand or in South Africa in general, that bone is more prominent in the males than the females, but it is very, very pronounced on the species here. So much so that I once saw one that almost looked, not quite, but about half the length of the ossicones or the horns on the top of his head. So those are the ossicones. A giraffe is born with them, hence why they're not called horns. All right, we're going to leave one spotted creature in search of the next. While we do, let's go across to the animal that Hosanna might try and catch.